cooking for over 125,000 people that we feed in 10 days at the Rogers Cup. For me, it's something that I look forward to. It's one of my biggest projects every year since the time I've been here. Coming up to the last month before Rogers Cup, it's probably the busiest time for us because that's the time when things start actually coming together. The pieces of the jigsaw are finally coming together and you get to see the picture in reality as to what it is.
I always think about Rogers Cup from the minute it ends, whenever it is in August, until the minute it begins the following year. We always think about it and we develop new menus and new ideas so everything keeps in term with a new trend.
Do you ever get a chance to take in some of it as a fan and enjoy the tennis, or are you too busy?
If I told you I was too busy, I wouldn't tell you the truth. I mean, of course we're busy, but there are some times where I sneak a little bit of a half an hour or an hour of a match. I go to one of the suites and I sit there with the people, or I just stand there on the side, or I stand where the security are, where the media are. Like, I had a conversation with Andre Agassi when he was there, and we were reminiscing about the old site and how it used to be, where spectators couldn't make a sound. You had to sit on your hands. Whereas today is different. Everybody wears funky colors. It's more of a happening. It's not like this upper crust people watching, turning their head like this with a ball in utter silence. It's become so much fun. When the buzz keeps getting larger and larger, and I have to say one thing we're so excited about this year is the subway, because suddenly all the people that maybe would find it difficult or a little bit of a challenge to come to the Rogers Cup, the challenge is gone, because all they have to do is come on the subway and we will be ready to welcome them with open arms and lots of food.
And now they can have a beer or a signature drink
their food. They can have a beer, they can have a signature drink or two, and they don't have to worry.
Can you tell us a little bit about what inspires you in the kitchen?
Many factors inspire me as a chef, but one of the biggest things that inspire me for being able to put out the flavors that I do, my mother and my grandmother. Both these ladies have been such tremendous influences, not just on my palate, but even on the way that I put food out and I think about it. That's, I think, what is being reflected in the food that most people taste when I cook for them.
One of your roles this summer at Rogers Cup will, of course, be as one of our celebrity chefs doing a cooking demo for the fans. Are you looking forward to that?
Oh, yes. It's something that I have been thinking about a lot. I'm still working on something really nice that I can come up with for the fans to inspire them and also to bring tennis and food together. For that, you have to come to tennis to see.
You're not going to give it away
now? No. You've got to be there to experience it. It's going to be amazing, that much I can tell you. And cooking for people is something that I do every day. To do it for a live audience in front of me, wow, it's going to be fantastic. And to even do it probably with a tennis player beside me, I mean, what more can I ask for?